Hello everyone, in previous lecture series, we discussed how to obtain initial feasible solutions and optimal solutions to a particular transportation problem. So in this video, we are going to discuss another special type of linear programming problems that is known as or called as assignment problems. In practical life, there are some situations in which we need to make assignment of different jobs to different workers or different machines to different operators or different sales territories to different salesmen. So these are some examples of typical assignment problems. As we know that different people have different capabilities and set of skills, and that's why they do a particular task in a different time or in a different manner, and in turn would cost the organization in a different way. So the question is how the assignment should be done in order to minimize the total time or total cost. So in this video, we have a typical assignment problem with us in which there are five workers and we need to assign to them the five machines. So we should make the allocation in such a way that we can minimize the total time taken to complete these tasks. Okay, so you can see the assignment problem is very much like the transportation problem, but there are two basic difference between transportation problem and assignment problem. First one is that the payoff matrix of assignment problem would always be a square matrix. What does it mean? It means that the number of columns should always be equal to the number of rows. Okay, the number of workers should always be equal to the number of machines. Okay. And what is the second condition? Second condition is that in a particular row or column, there would be only one assignment. What does it mean? That we can assign to worker one only one machine. It can be machine 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If suppose it is machine 3, then there would be no other assignment in this particular row. So we have to, there would be one-to-one assignment, one worker to one machine or one machine to one worker. And as if you remember that in transportation problem, there can be different assignments, more than one assignments in a particular row or column. So these are basic two differences between assignment problems and transportation problems. So now we come to the solution part of this problem, how to solve the assignment problems or how to obtain the optimal solution to the assignment problems. So there are different methods to reach to the optimal solution. And first one is simplex method. Again, the assignment problems can be solved with the help of simplex method. Second one is transportation method. Third one is complete enumeration method, and the fourth one is Hungarian assignment method. Hungarian assignment method. In this video, particularly we would focus on Hungarian assignment method only. So these three methods have their respective limitations when it comes to the assignment problems. So in this video, we would focus only on Hungarian assignment method. Let's start the solution part of this problem. These are some steps that should be followed while calculating the optimal solution to the assignment problem. In step one, so this is the basic table or initial table. Select the smallest cost element in each row. We need to select smallest cost element in each row and subtract it from each element in that particular row. Suppose in the first row, the smallest cost element is 2. So we need to subtract this element from each element of this row. Similarly, in second row, the smallest element is 2. Again, we need to reduce or subtract this element from each row element. In third row, the minimum is 2. In fourth one, again it is 2. And in fifth one, it is
6. So coincidentally, all the smallest elements are in a similar column. So what we have to do, we need to reduce the smallest element from each element in that particular row. So in first row, the smallest element is 2. So reduce this element from each element. So 10 minus 2 would be 8, 3 minus 2, 1, 3 minus 2, 1, 2 minus 2, 0, and 8 minus 2, 6. Similarly, in second row, reduce this one from each element of that row. 9 minus 2, 7, 7 minus 2, 5, 8 minus 2, 6, 2 minus 2, 0, and 7 minus 5. 7 minus 2 is 5. So in a similar manner, for each row, we need to perform this step one by one. So after applying the first step on this table, we would get this table. It is the second table of this question. Now, what is the step 2? Repeat step 1 for each column. So now in second step, what we have to do? Simply select the smallest value in each column and subtract it from each element of that particular column, including the element itself. Like in first column, the minimum or smallest number is 1. So reduce 1 or subtract 1 from each element of the first column. So 8 minus 1, 7, 7 minus 1, 6, 5 minus 1, 4, 1 minus 1, 0, and 3 minus 2, 3 minus 1, 2. Similarly, in second column, the smallest element is 1. So reduce this element from each element of this column. 1 minus 1, 0, 5 minus 4, 1, 2 minus 1, 1, 3 minus 1, 2, 4 minus 1, 3. Similarly, in third column, it is 1. Reduce 1 from, subtract 1 from each element of this column. 1 minus 1, 0, 6 minus 1, 4, 5, 4 minus 1, 3, 6 minus 1, 5, and 3 minus 2, 3 minus 1, 2. In the fourth column, 0 is the smallest element and there would be no impact on this column. So it would be as it is. In column 5, the smallest element is 2. So there is a tie between the smallest element. So you can take either one, there would be no impact of it. 6 minus 2, 4, 5 minus 2, 3, 2 minus 2, 0, 2 minus 2, 0, and 4 minus 2, 2. So now we have reached to the third table of this problem. Now come to the third step. What we have to do in third step? Draw the minimum number of horizontal and vertical lines to cover all zero elements. To cover all zero elements. So we need to draw the minimum number of lines horizontally or vertically, not diagonally, to cover all the zero elements in this table. So let's start. We try to cover the maximum zeros with a line. So look at the column 4. So we can draw we can cover all these zero elements with a single line by drawing it vertically. In this way, we can cover all zero elements of column 4 with only single line by drawing a vertical line. Now look at the table. And in the first row, we can cover 2 zeros with a single line. Okay. Now in come to the column 5, we can cover 2 zero elements with a line. Cover these elements. Now we left with this one. So cover this zero element either by drawing a horizontal line or by drawing a vertical line. It is not going to impact anything. So we can draw like it in a vertical way. In this manner. It is 6. Okay, I think every element is clear. Now, what is the next thing we need to do? Draw the minimum number of horizontal or vertical lines to cover all zero elements and check if number of such lines is equal to n or not. So what is the meaning of n? N denotes the number of rows or number of columns. In this table, the number of rows is equal to 5 or the number of columns is equal to 5. In assignment problems, the number of rows would be equal to number of columns in any case. So n denotes basically either number of columns or number of rows. So what is the number of lines we have drawn in this table? It is 1, 2, 3 and 4. And what is the n? N is 5. So n is equal to 5 and number of lines drawn is 4. So number of lines drawn is smaller than n or smaller than 5. And the condition of optimal solution is that if the number of lines drawn is equal to n, then the solution is optimal. And if it is not the case, then the solution is not optimal. In our problem, in this case, the number of lines drawn is smaller than n. So this is not the optimal solution. So we need to improve this solution. If just in case, if our solution was optimal, then we don't need to go to step 4 or step 5. We can go directly to the step 6. But the solution is not optimal, then we should go through step 4 and step 5 also. So the solution is not optimal, then go to step 4. Select the smallest uncovered cost. The smallest uncovered cost that is not covered by any line. Smallest uncovered cost. In this table, the smallest uncovered cost is, it is 2, again 2, 2. So you can take any one, you can select any one, because there is a tie between smallest one, 2, 2. So smallest cost is 2, you can take any one. And subtract it from all uncovered elements. So what we need to do? We need to subtract this element from all the uncovered elements. So I am formulating a new table. So it is machine 1, machine 2, machine 3, machine 4 and machine 5. Worker 1, worker 2, worker 3, worker 4 and worker 5. So what we need to do now? Simply subtract the smallest element from the all of the uncovered elements. So what are those uncovered elements? It is 4. So in this table, I'm going to write all the elements one by one. So it is 7, 6, 4, 0. Later on, we will make the adjustments. 0, 4, 2, 2, 3, 0, 5, 3, 5, 2, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 4, 3, 0, 0, 2. Yes. So what we need to do? Subtract this element, smallest element, from all of the uncovered elements. So reduce it, subtract 2 from 4. It would be 2. So instead 4, it would be 2. Subtract 2 from 5. It would be equal to 3. Subtract it from 3, it would be 1. Subtract this element from itself, 2 minus 2, it would be 0. 2 minus 2, again, it would be 0. 5 minus 2, it would be 3. 3 minus 2, 1, and 2 minus 2, again, it would be 0. And what is the next step? Including itself and add to each cost element located at the intersection of two lines. So we need to add the smallest element to those elements which are located at intersection of two lines. Okay, intersection of two lines, remember. So 7 is located at the intersection of two points, two lines. So the smallest value would be added into this element. So 7 plus 2 would be equal to 9.
And look at the other elements which are located at the intersection of two lines. It is this one, 0.
So this 0 would be 0 plus 2, 2.
Again, 4.
4 plus 2, it would be 6.
Is there any another element? No, there is no. Only 4 elements. 1, 2, 3. Basically, there are only 3 elements which are located at intersection of two lines.
So there would be no impact on those elements which were covered by only single line. So there would be no impact on them. Now we have the improved solution with us.
After applying fourth step, we have the improved solution with us.
Now what we have to do? Repeat step 4 and 5. Repeat step 4 and 5. Now again we have so many zero elements in this table. We again need to draw minimum number of lines to cover all the zero elements in this table. So let's start. This column has 4 zero elements. So first we are going to cover this element, column. Then we can cover these 3 zeros with a single line, vertical line. After that, we can cover these 2 zeros, then these 2 zeros we can cover, and in the end we have only 1 zero left. So we can cover it either by drawing a vertical line or horizontal line. So let's, for simplicity, we are drawing a vertical line. Now count the number of lines we have drawn to cover the zero elements of the table. Now in this case the number of lines drawn is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It means the number of lines drawn to cover zero elements is equal to n. It means in this step we got the optimal solution. So this is going to be our optimal solution. We are going to use this matrix to calculate the optimal solution. So how we are going to find out the optimal solution? That is step 6. Assign the jobs. How we are going to assign the jobs to the different machines? So I'm going to clear this table, as we need to draw one more table here. I'm redrawing this table. So here is machine 1, 2, 3, machine 4 and machine 5. Worker 1, worker 2, worker 3, worker 4 and worker 5. So I am going to rewrite all these elements in this table. That is 9, 6, 4, 0, 2. 0, 2, 0, 0, 1. 0, 3, 1, 3, 0, 2, 0, 0, 0, 0, 6, 3, 0, 0, and 2. So we have the table with the optimal solution. So I'm going to clear it. Now it's time to apply or to assign the jobs to particular workers. Like in step 6, what we need to do? In the first, we need to locate a row or column which contains only one zero. So in this particular table, we need to identify a row or column which contains only one zero element. So you can see, in first column, we have only one zero. And do we have in any other row or column a single zero element? No, there is no single row. Yes. In this row, we have only one row, in this particular row. So locate the row or column which contains only one zero. So what is the meaning of obtaining only single zero? It means in this column, that is of machine 1, we are going to allocate machine 1 to worker 4. So worker 4 would be allocated machine 1. Machine 1. Now what would be next thing to be done? Cross out the zero elements in row and column corresponding to that particular element or that particular zero element. So related to this element, we are going to cross the all these zero elements in the rows or columns which are related with this. So it means we are going to cross or the zero elements in this particular row. So what is the meaning of crossing the row, crossing the zero elements of the row? It means that the worker 4 is no longer available for any machine, because we have allocated machine 1 to worker 4. So there would be no allocation to worker 4. That's why we are going to cross or eliminate all the zero elements in that particular row. Okay, now come to the next row or element that contains only single zero element. So in this row we have only one zero element. So we are going to assign worker 2 the machine 4. So machine 4 would be assigned to worker 2. Now what we need to do, again step 2, cross out the zero elements in row and columns corresponding to that zero element. So we are going to cross all the zero elements in this column. So it is the, we would cross it, this one and this one. So what is the meaning of crossing all the zeros in this column? It means the machine 4 is not available for any of the worker, because we have allocated machine 4 to worker 2. Okay, after crossing all the zeros, now again look for or locate a row or column which contains only single row or column, and we are not going to consider all the crossed zero elements. So look at the last row. In this row we have only a single zero element, because we have already crossed this one. That means we are not going to consider this. So this row contains only one or single zero element. So what is the meaning of single zero in this row? It means worker 5 is going to get machine 3. Worker 5 is going to get machine 3. So after assigning this machine to worker 5, now we need to cross out all the zero elements corresponding to this particular cell. So this particular cell, to this particular cell, this column is corresponding. So we are going to cross this zero. Now again look for or search for the row or column which contain only single zero element. So this one, this row, this column contains only single zero element. It means worker 3 would be assigned the machine 5. After assigning machine 5 to worker 3, eliminate all the or cross all the zero elements corresponding to this element. So in this row, this zero element is going to be crossed. Now look for the last one. As we have assigned machine 1 to worker 4, machine 4 to worker 2, machine 3 to worker 5, and machine 5 to worker 3, it means we are left with machine 2 and worker 1. So there is no another option we have. So we are going to allocate machine 2 to worker 1. Machine 2 to worker 1. So in this way we assigned different machines to different workers. Now the last step, what would be the total cost or total time taken to complete these jobs or these tasks? It would be equal to just go to the table 1, as we don't have the values. So I'm writing for the book. Always consider the actual table for calculating the total cost or total time. Yes, we have assigned worker 4 the machine 1. So worker 4 is going to take how much time on machine 1 worker 4 is going to take. Worker 4 going to take 3 minutes or 3 hours, it can be any unit of the time. Worker 2 is going to take on machine 4 2 minutes, and worker 5 on machine 3 is going to take 9 minutes, and worker 3 on machine 5, worker 3 on machine 5 is going to take 4 minutes, and worker 1 is going to take on machine 1, that is equal to again 3 minutes. So total time or total cost would be equal to 3 plus 2, 5 plus 9, 14 plus 4, 18 plus 3, 21. So 21 minutes or 21 hours is the total minimum time or cost that we are going to take in completion of a specific task on different machines and performed by different workers. So in this manner we have calculated the total time consumed by 5 workers to complete the 5 tasks on different machines. So this is a typical process to calculate the optimal solution of the assignment problems. Like transportation problems, there are some special cases of assignments problems also. So first case is the case of unbalanced assignment problems. Unbalanced assignment problems means it can be in two situations. In situation one, the number of rows is greater than the number of columns. It means the number of rows is greater than the number of columns. And second case can be the number of columns is greater than number of rows. So like we did in the transportation problem, in first condition we are going to add a dummy column or a dummy machine with like machine 6. We are going to add a dummy machine to balance out the assignment problem with zero cost or time, because in reality we are not going to perform any task on machine 6. So the cost or time would be equal to zero. In case number 2, when number of columns are greater than rows, in that condition we are going to add an additional row in the bottom of the assignment matrix in a similar way, zero cost or zero time. So in this way we can handle unbalanced assignment problems. And the second special case of assignment problems is the constraint assignment problems or assignment problems with prohibited routes. It means there would be some workers which cannot work on some machines. Like in this table, worker 2 cannot work on machine 2. Worker 2 is prohibited or constrained to work on machine 2. So in that case, what we are going to do, simply like we did in transportation problem, we are going to assign a large cost close to infinity, a large cost that is close to infinity to assign in that particular cell. It means in this manner, we would eliminate this particular route or this particular combination in final solution. So this is the way of handling the special cases of assignment problems. Thank you. The third special case of assignment problem can be related with unique or multiple optimal solution. It means sometimes we are not able to locate a row or column with single zero element. Sometimes we may face a situation in which there are more than one zero elements in every row or column. So that would be the case of multiple optimal solutions. In that condition, we can select any of the zero element in a particular row or column. So that would be the unique or multiple optimal solution of an assignment problem. So in this way, we can handle the assignment problems with the help of Hungarian assignment method. This method is considered the most efficient and effective one among all the methods we have listed out here, because this method is based on opportunity cost or opportunity time that is given in the payoff matrix of an assignment problem. So thank you.